In 1992, the greatest array of basketball talent ever assembled on one team took the court to represent the United States at the Olympics in Barcelona, Spain. The dream team won gold with class and ease. Yet their greatest game went unseen because it was played in an empty gym. Jack McCallum reveals the greatest game that no one ever saw.
The Dream Team was a phenomenon, to use the cliche, of kind of a perfect storm. I always say that's the hardest thing to do in sports, to be better than your hype. This was the most hyped team of all time. When they finally got together, they delivered in a way that we didn't think was possible. Over the years, there's one basketball nugget that everybody talks about, and I call it the greatest game nobody ever saw. It took place during the Dream Team practice in Monte Carlo. Chuck Daly, the coach, said, we're going to get together, really knock each other's heads out a little bit. And to make sure that he was able to accomplish that, he put Michael Jordan on one team, and he put Magic Johnson on the other team. He kicked everybody out of the gym, and it was filmed by Chuck's personal video guy. In November of 1991, Magic announced to the world that he had the HIV virus. He was retiring from the game. Now here it is in late June. Magic Johnson was not only back, he was the captain of the Dream Team. Michael Jordan at this time was probably the most famous athlete on the planet. Everyone knew that Michael was the guy, but Magic just would not pay heed to that. Well, the game starts out, and Magic's team gets way ahead. And Magic, as is his wont, starts jawing a little bit. Well, there was a moment early in the scrimmage when Michael Jordan came down court, and he made a jump shot, and it was lucky, and one that Jordan simply didn't intend. Magic got the ball. He stopped at the three-point line. He took a shot, and he said, right back at you. And I think it was at that moment when something went through Magic Johnson's head that said, I can duel this guy one-on-one. I mean, it's funny, because he was the most unselfish player, you know, to ever play the game. I mean, here's a guy that only wanted to win, that didn't need to shoot. But it was very hard for Magic to kind of surrender the ground to somebody else. And as it progressed, the taunts became a little more personal. Michael's theme was, hey man, it's the 90s. It's not the 80s anymore. It's over for you. This is kind of my game now. Michael's team caught up. And finally, Jordan's team holds on to win. And when it was all over, you could really see that something was hovering in the air. Magic's over there shooting alone, and he's jawing at Michael, and Michael is jawing back. Finally, Michael starts singing the Gatorade song, Be Like Mike, rubbing it in a little bit, as is Jordan's wont. To this day, Michael Jordan calls it the most fun he ever had on a basketball court. I'm not saying this was the last generation of NBA players who enjoyed the game, who played for the fun of it, but this game was for the fun of it. This game was for the pride. This game was for the respect. But here you had 10 of the best players in the world who are basically knocking themselves out in this nondescript gym on a nondescript morning in an otherwise nondescript practice. And that's what resonated with me.